Hi everyone, meet Nadia. Nadia is a computer scientist. A computer scientist is a person who creates computer games like software and apps you can use on your tablet. Other computer scientists create programs that use VR. VR stands for virtual reality. Virtual reality refers to the three-dimensional images that people can see. Virtual reality can be used in many settings. For example, athletes can wear special VR glasses that will let them practice certain plays before a game. Virtual reality can also be used in medicine so doctors can see surgeries that were performed by other doctors before performing the procedure themselves. They will be able to experience what it would be like to perform a complex heart surgery. How cool is that? Today, Yvette is creating special glasses that use VR in educational settings. These glasses will be worn by students during their social studies class. When kids put on the VR glasses, they will be able to see three-dimensional images and feel as if they were walking around as an American colonist who lived when the British ruled over them in the late 1700s. Yvette wants the glasses to have three buttons on the side. When users wear the glasses, they will be able to click on the buttons to see different images that represent the colonies during this time. When users click on the first button, they will be able to see how colonists were protesting and rioting in the streets after the Stamp Act was passed. The Stamp Act said that every piece of paper in the colonies was to be taxed. The money raised from this tax was going to the British government. Newspapers, letters, paper, and even playing cards were taxed. The colonists were angry because they did not want to pay taxes. They felt that they were being taxed by a government where they were not represented. The protesters' slogan was, "No taxation without representation." The Stamp Act was so unpopular that teapots with "No Stamp Act" written on them were made. When users push the second button, they will be able to see the British reaction to the protests in the colony. The British economy relied on colonial business, so the British government was nervous that the protests and boycotts of British goods would cost them lots of money. They were also nervous that they could not control the colonists. Britain heard about the protests in the colonies and eventually repealed the act in 1766. However, they created new acts that applied new taxes to the colonies to try and reinforce their power over the colonists. When users push the third button, they will see images of colonists protesting another act that was passed. This rule was called the Tea Act and was passed in 1773. The Tea Act reduced the price of British tea that was imported to the colonists. The new price of British tea was less than the price of tea from other countries. This upset colonists because this tea was also taxed by the British. The colonists did not want to pay taxes to Britain. When users push the fourth button, they will be able to see colonists protesting again. The colonists dumped the tea into the Boston Harbor to show the British that they were not going to purchase their tea. Yvette is glad that her students now understand part of the reason the colonists wanted to be independent from Britain. Now it's your turn to go on an adventure and be a computer scientist.